talk about the condition of women in Saudi Arabia. You were telling me it can range from someone, a woman of great privilege, to a woman with very, very little, and yet they have a lot in common, too.
There is a full range of women, from the conservative to the modern, but the bulk are in lives where they see mostly their female relatives, and they don't mix with men who are not immediately related. I went to a home with a man who wanted me to meet his wife, and his brother was there, and his wife would not come into the room until his brother departed the room, because he was a man of a young man, and therefore she could have been attracted to him, and this is not, you know, just the lengths that people go to be religiously observant.
And to keep women from being
to keep women and men from
mixing. How much clamor is there among these women to change that?
Well, some of them have changed it. I talked to one young woman who said, I lead a Western life. She leads it in private. Her parents let her have men, you know, young guys to dinner at their home. I mean, you don't do that in public. But, you know, all the way to women like the religious lady I lived with, who does not want anything to change and thinks it's the road to hell to have any change, to have women drive or women working around men. But you do see that. There are poorer women who are working in a flower factory. There are women here cutting the leaves off of roses, and there are men right there doing the same thing. It's not supposed to happen, but it happens.
Completely different question. What do the rulers of Saudi Arabia want to have happen to come out of this so-called Arab Spring? What to them is a desired outcome? What do they worry about?
I think what they want for Saudi Arabia, some of them, is to kind of wind up like Malaysia, to have a country that's very Islamic but a bit more modernized. I think the Saudis look at what's going on in the Middle East and fear democracy, more demands for a greater say, so that you see the Saudis now not supporting the Muslim Brotherhood in Egypt, supporting the Salafis, a more conservative form, and obviously not really supporting democracy in Tunisia. And my concern is that as they try to head off democracy and even the Muslim Brotherhood, which people here worry about,
right,
that's too democratic for them, that they are again sowing the seeds of breeding a jihadist mentality in the region by their support again of this Salafist philosophy to try to counter democracy in the region. The Muslim Brotherhood is democratically elected, and it's a problem for them because Saudis will ultimately want more say, and some already do.
Karen Elliott House, thank you very much.
Thank you.